I was charged with assault in Central Ohio. What do I need to know? I'm Sean Domini. I'm a criminal defense lawyer with the Domini Law Firm in Columbus, Ohio, and this video is going to answer that question. One of the first things you should know is that there are various ways that the offense of assault can be committed. And I think of those in basically three categories. The first is negligent assault. The second is what you'd consider standard assault. And the third is felonious assault. So let's talk about negligent assault first. So if you, through negligence, cause physical harm to another person by means of a deadly weapon or dangerous ordinance, that's negligent assault. In Ohio, it's categorized as a third-degree misdemeanor. That means you can get a fine of up to $500 and you can get a jail sentence up to 60 days, as well as 5 years of probation. The second type of assault is what I've referred to as standard assault. The law doesn't call it that, but that's the most common one. And that is committed when you knowingly cause or attempt to cause physical harm to another person. Assault is categorized in Ohio as a first-degree misdemeanor, which means you can get up to a $1,000 fine and up to 6 months in jail, as well as 5 years of probation. Then the third type of assault is felonious assault. Again, there are different ways it can be committed, but the most common one is causing serious physical harm rather than just physical harm for standard assault. The felonious assault involves serious physical harm to another person. Felonious assault is categorized typically as a second degree felony, which means you can get a prison term up to 8 years. At the Domini Law Firm, we represent clients for all types of assault. I've been practicing since 1997. Brian's been practicing since 2011. We have both handled many assault cases. In fact, Brian has handled more than I have. When we represent a client for a charge of assault, whichever type it is, we take the same thorough approach. We collect all the facts, involving an investigator if necessary, but we want to know all the facts of the case first. And then we do some legal research to determine if we can keep out harmful evidence or otherwise help our strategy in court. Third, we prepare for a trial. Even though most cases don't go to trial, we prepare like the case is going to go to trial. Number one, in case it does, and number two, because doing that helps with our negotiations with the prosecutor, which is typically the next step. And so when we negotiate with the prosecutor, hopefully we find an agreement which you find acceptable. If we don't, then we have a trial and make the prosecution prove your guilt beyond a reasonable doubt if they can. All that time, we're also working on mitigation, and that means trying to mitigate the sentence, make the sentence more lenient. We take that approach in every case. And if you have a case of assault, any of those types that I've described, and if it's in Central Ohio, we'd be glad to talk to you about it. If you'd like to contact us to schedule a free phone consultation, there are a couple ways you can do that. You can call the number on the screen, or you can fill out a contact form on our website. In any event, we'd be glad to hear from you and talk with you, and we hope that this information has been helpful.